Is that a fish? Is it a heart? Is it a bird?
Yeah.
Is it a
Superman?
We are getting ready to read a story called Your Special by Max Lucado. The Wimmicks were small wooden people. All of the wooden people were carved by a woodworker named Eli. His workshop sat on a hill overlooking their village. Each Wimmick was different. Some had big noses, others smaller jaws. Some were tall and others were short. Some wore hats, others wore coats. But all were made by the same carver and all lived in the village.
In all day, every day, the Wimmicks did the same thing. They each gave each other stickers, each Wimmick had a box of Boy Scout stickers, and a box of Grey Dog stickers. Up and down the street, all over the city, people spent their day spending stars and dogs on one another. The pretty one, those with smooth wooden and fine paint, always got stars. But his wooden and rough wooden paint was chipped and Wimmicks was tops.
The talented ones got stars too. Some could lift big sticks high above their heads or jump over tall boxes. Still others used big words or could sing pretty songs. Everyone could sing stars. Some Wimmicks had stars all over them. Every time they got a star, it made them feel so good. It made them want to do something else and get another star. Others, though, could do little things.
Punchinello was one of these. He tried to jump high like the others, but he always fell. And when he fell, the others would gather around and give him dots. Sometimes, when he fell, his wood got scratched, so the people would give him more dots. Then when he would try to explain why he fell, he would say something silly and the Wimmicks would give him more dots. After a while, he had so many dots that he didn't want to go outside. He was afraid he would do something silly, such as forget his hat or step in the water, and the people would give him more dots. In fact, he had so many gray dots that some people would come up and give him a dot for no reason at all.
He deserved lots of dots. The wooden people were great to one another. He's not a good wooden person. After a while, Punchinello believed them. I'm not a good Wimmick, he would say. A few times he went outside, he had a look at the Wimmicks, played a lot of dots. He felt better around them.
One day, he met a Wimmick who was unlike any he ever met. She had no dots or stars. She was just wooden. Her name was Lucia. It wasn't that people didn't try to give her stickers. It's just that the stickers didn't stick. Some of the Wimmicks admired Lucia for having no dots. So they would run up and give her a star, but it would fall off. Others would look down on her for having no stars, so they would give her a dot, but it wouldn't stay either.
That's where I wanted to be, thought Punchinello. I don't want anyone's marks. So he asked the stickerless Wimmick, how she did it. It's easy, Lucy Young replied. Every day I go see Eli.
Eli?
Yes, Eli, the woodcarver. I sit in his workshop with him.
Why?
Why don't you find out yourself? Go up the hill, get there. And with that, the woman who had no sugars turned and skipped away.
But will he want to see me? Marcinella cried out. Lucia didn't hear, so Marcinella went home. He sat near a window and watched the light of his glass and scurried around, giving each other stars and dots. It's not right, he muttered to himself, and he decided to go see Eli.
He walked up to the narrow path to the top of the hill and stepped into the big shop, his wooden eyes widened at the size of everything. Punchinello swallowed hard. I'm not staying here. And he turned to leave. Then he heard his name. Punchinello? The voice was deep and strong. Punchinello stopped. Punchinello, how good to see you. Come and let me have a look at you. Punchinello turned slowly and looked at the large craftsman. You know my name? The little woodman asked. Of course I do. I made you.
Eli stooped down and picked him up and set him on the bench. The major stood thoughtfully as he looked at the gray dots. Looks like you've been given some bad marks. I didn't mean to, Eli. I really tried hard. Oh, you don't have to defend yourself, lovely child. I don't care what the other mermaids think. You don't? No, and you shouldn't either. Who are they to give stars for dots? They're mermaids just like you. What they think doesn't matter about your blood. All that matters is what I think. And I think you're pretty special.
Janelle laughed. Me? Special? Why? I can't walk fast. I can't jump. My paint is peeling. Why do I matter to you? You ought to look at me now. Put his hand on the small wooden shoulders and spoke very slowly. Because you're mine. That's why you matter to me. Punchinello had never had anyone look at him like this, much less his major. He didn't know what to say.
Every day I've been hoping you come to my stories. I came because I met someone who had no marks, Punchinello. I know, she told me about you. Why don't the singers say to her? The maker said softly. Because she has decided that what I think is more important than what they think. The stickers only stick if you want them.
What?
The stickers only stick if they matter to you. The more you trust my love, the less you care about their stickers. I'm not sure I understand.
Eli smiled. You will, but it will take time. You've got a lot of marks. For now, just come see me every day. And let me remind you how much I care. Eli lifted Punchinello off the bench and set him on the ground. Remember, Eli said as the woman walked out the door, you are special because I made you, and I don't make mistakes. Punchinello didn't stop, but in his heart he thought, I really think he means it. And when he did, a dog fell to the ground.
Have you ever felt like Punchinello? Well, God wants us to know just how special we are to him. The Bible tells us that we're all made in God's image. That means we all have
somebody does something wrong, I'll forgive them right away. Hebrews 8:12 says, I will forgive their wickedness and remember their sins no more.
I reflect God's image by being joyful. I am always happy for people and rejoice in the little things of mine. Psalm 40:16 says, but may all who seek you rejoice and be glad in you. May those who long for your saving help always say, the Lord is great. I reflect God's image by being careful of what I say. I try to think before I say the words out loud. Psalms 19:14 says, may these words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be pleasing in your sight, Lord, my rock and my redeemer.
I can share God's love by showing happiness. I'm joyful by having a good attitude in life and every day. Psalm 68:3 says, but may the righteous be glad and rejoice before God, and they may be happy and joyful.
I can share God's love by showing thankfulness. Always thank God for being my friends and family. 1 Chronicles 16:34 says, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever.
For boys and girls, if you'll get into singer's position, so we can sing the Lord's Prayer.